But, you know, we give this to those babies just to kind of keep them quiet sometimes, don't we? It does wonders. Baby can be crying and crying. Where's that pacifier? They start sucking away and they're satisfied for a little while anyway. I think it might fool them. They think something's coming. They keep sucking that thing and nothing's coming out. But it soothes them for a while, doesn't it? Then the problem on the other end is that they get so used to it, we have a problem getting them off of it. So now, we're trying to break them of the pacifier. The thing that served us so well, we're trying to break them of that pacifier because they got used to that thing. God, it soothes them. I might keep this up here for my sermon. God is having to analyze me right now. Yeah. But you know, we have things that pacify us too.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, we might us for a moment, or we might get some anxiety, and we might have to do something to pacify us. I won't ask you what it is, but sometimes we have those things that pacify us. Now, I'm not implying anything here, but we have had the biggest weekend for spending money this weekend. And perhaps when we spend, sometimes we are trying to pacify. I'm just, you know, I know that can be with me, and God can say amen on that. But, you know, sometimes we might have to go out and buy something to kind of pacify us wanting something, right? A lot of different ways that we try to use our own pacifiers. As a matter of fact, we get so used to those things pacifying us, it's hard for us to get off of those pacifiers, isn't it? And they're a whole lot bigger than this, a lot more expensive than this. Because we look for something to soothe us. We need pacifying, if you will. But what's interesting, when we do go to buy, this is why you have to ask you this question. Why do I buy? Why do I buy? You know, sometimes I'll be in that area of the store where it has impulse buying. They don't want to put those National Geographics and, you know, those Time Magazine. I came in with the superheroes the other day. Because it's all about superheroes, you know, the magazines. Or they also know where to put the gum and the candy and the impulse buying. They know where to put it. Many times, no, I don't need that right now. I have to convince myself not to allow that pacifying need in me to reach out and grab something or to buy it. Sometimes I get an urge to go by a certain store. I don't really need to go to that store today. But if I went in there, I probably bought something. To which Donna says, amen. But anyway. So we have to, why do I buy? And when we go to buy something, we have to ask, why do I buy? Because you know, when we make a decision to spend, it usually is a spiritual decision as well. Because there's spiritual things and principles attached to our money. That's why Jesus would say in Matthew chapter 6, he says, do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moth and rust do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. Hallelujah. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. So when we go to spend, we have to say, what am I spending for? Because spending usually has a spiritual decision as well. Because when we order our giving through tithing and giving to the Lord, recognize that it all has come from Him. Then we have prioritized our finances and how they are going to be spent. Not only that do we give to Him, but then He brings order to all of our finances that they will be spent for His glory and for His purpose. Given and also spent. Because when we give it to Him in tithing and offering, we're recognizing all the rest of it